I come from one of the seven or six monarchies, so I'm actually related to people in the government. And it's very important for me to try and identify ways in order to move the country forward into the 21st century and into the best practices, and find a segue into moving from a country that is based solely on the rule of monarchies into one where the citizens play an increasingly important role. I already was present in the media environment. However, social media allowed me to expand from being a local or a Gulf a person who's known in the Gulf region to somebody who's read in the Middle East, and then I discovered in the West and in the East. So social media was definitely a tool that before the Arab uprisings I was able to use in order to disseminate my ideas and to share my articles. We're such a small country, so for someone in the West, in the US or in Europe or even in the Middle East, to connect to somebody writing in English in the UAE or voicing his or her opinions in English, that was a novelty because there's so few of us. Through social media, there was this third wave of pan-Arabism occurred. When you had the first wave that in the 20th century, or the modern wave that was created through print media, and then you had radio and TV come in, and now you have social media that's connecting people from across the Arab world together. On social media, as soon as that official is seen tweeting, then he or she is criticized or praised if they do something well, I hope, but in general criticized for their performance or lack thereof. In many cases, policies have been changed because of social media interaction with these officials in the Middle East. In many cases, the Egyptian government announced its resignation under the military rule in 2012 on Facebook. Who would have thought? The program has definitely exceeded my expectations. I did not expect to be completely out of time. I did not expect to be to have this amount of information and knowledge shared on multiple levels, from the morning until we go to sleep, the interaction between the fellows, the interaction with the scholars, the interaction with the wonderful team that's been looking after us. I feel like every day I'm inspired by this galaxy of intellectuals who I have been reading of and about and for the better part of my adult life. And I can just name scholar after scholar who's come and addressed us. And after being starstruck for a few minutes, it really is very, very important just to absorb these ideas and interact with these scholars and ask them questions and try to see how their ideas that are written for a broader audience, how these ideas can apply for individual states and regions.